We are beginning on the Crime Watch and continuing concerns over violence and crime in Santa Cruz. Over the weekend, two more heroin arrests in the city, plus an assault with a deadly weapons arrest. And after a party got out of control on Archer Drive, one man hit a police officer. All of this reinforcing concerns in the community over rising violence. And tonight they got together to talk about ways to try and, well, keep kids safe and change things. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live in our newsroom with more.
Aaron, teens got involved tonight. The age group directly involved with the recent violence wants input on changes they want their city to make.
...16-year-old Jasmine Williams wanted to send a message to her community Monday night.
The fact that Tyler lost his life is like a real realization. I want just everyone to realize that it's here. It's what we need to change right now. It's not something that is far away. It is right here, right now.
Right now, as community members come together to discuss solutions to youth violence. A conversation jump-started by the stabbing death of 16-year-old Tyler Tenorio in mid-October on a Santa Cruz street.
Everyone should be realizing that we all have to take care of each other as a community.
Teens say they felt compelled to express their concerns to the diverse crowd that filled the civic auditorium.
A lot of the violence that's been in this community has been with and from and by people my age, and I thought I'd like to come out because often we're not included in discussions about how we want to change our city.
Change that is already a work in progress for the city.
Of course, the criminal investigations, but we've also been doing as much outreach as we can to the community. We have bilingual officers going door to door in certain neighborhoods where we know that there has been prior gang activity.
And Santa Cruz City school leaders were also on hand, who say if they do their job right, kids won't be tempted to resort to gangs.
They're busy doing their homework and involved with sports and music programs and so forth. They don't have time for or the interest in violence or gang activity.
Monday night, community members joined in small groups to address issues and come up with ideas, all in an effort to keep youth safe and stop gang violence on Santa Cruz streets.
If they're walking home at night or if they're just hanging out downtown, that they're going to make it home safely and not have to deal with any issues.
We as a community need to step up and do something about it. And we can't just send all those people out and just be like, all those gangbangers need to get out. We have to step up and take care of them, because if you just kick them out, it's just going to the next community.
Now, police say they will continue going door-to-door in those target neighborhoods for at least another week or so. Also, the city's mayor says, Aaron, that she hopes tonight's discussion leads to some answers that these community agencies can really implement and see results from.
All right, Brittany, thank you.